Good morning. Today we are going to solve free response question number one from the 2015 AP Physics 1 exam.
Flipping physics.
We have block 1 and block 2 connected by a string of negligible mass. That string goes over two pulleys. Those pulleys have negligible mass and negligible friction. And the mass of block 2 is greater than the mass of block 1. Part A asks us to draw the free body diagrams for the forces acting on each block. Billy, could you start, please?
Well, each block has a force of gravity acting downwards on it, and the mass of block 2 is greater than the mass of block 1, so the length of the arrow for the force of gravity acting on block 2 should be longer than the length of the arrow for the force of gravity acting on block 1.
Bo, please continue.
There is a tension force in the string, and it acts up on both blocks.
And because the string and pulleys have no mass, the magnitudes of those two tension forces are the same. Oh, and because the pulleys have no friction.
But how long should we draw the tension forces?
Well, because block 2 has a larger force of gravity acting on it than block 1, block 1 will accelerate upward, and block 2 will accelerate downward.
Therefore, the tension force has to be larger in magnitude than the force of gravity 1 to cause block 1 to accelerate upward, and the tension force also has to be smaller in magnitude than force of gravity 2 to cause block 2 to accelerate downward.
Great. That is the answer to part A. Now, I do want to take a moment to pause to reiterate the importance of free body diagrams or force diagrams. On the AP test, your free body diagrams are a part of your solution. Therefore, you need to draw them carefully and legibly. You need to make sure that the lengths of your arrows matches the relative lengths of those force vectors. You need to make sure that you name your vectors, you label your force vectors so that they can identify which forces you're talking about. And if you need to break forces into components, first draw a component-free free body diagram, then break forces into components, and then redraw a free body diagram with those components.
Did anybody else notice the soapbox Mr. P is standing on?
Crikey, Bo! Quit that codswallop! He's only trying to help!
Alright, let's move on. Part B asks for us to derive the magnitude of the acceleration of block 2.
Mr. P?
Yes, Bobby?
Don't both blocks have the same acceleration because they are attached by the string?
Bobby, that is correct. That is actually why we are going to find the magnitude of the acceleration of both blocks simultaneously by summing the forces on the whole system. But first, we need to identify the positive direction, which is going to be up for block 1 and down for block 2, the direction we know both blocks are going to accelerate. Bobby, please?
The net force on both blocks in the positive direction you just showed is positive force of gravity 2 minus force of tension plus force of tension minus force of gravity 1, and the net force also equals mass times acceleration, which would be the total mass times the acceleration of both blocks. The two tension forces cancel one another out, and we can substitute in mass 2 times acceleration due to gravity for force of gravity 2. And mass 1 times acceleration due to gravity for force of gravity 1, and mass 1 plus mass 2 for the total mass. Divide both sides by mass 1 plus mass 2, and we have our answer. Acceleration equals mass 2 times acceleration due to gravity minus mass 1 times acceleration due to gravity, all divided by the quantity mass 1 plus mass 2.
Very nice. You'll notice I actually went one step further. I pulled the acceleration due to gravity out, which isn't absolutely necessary, but it looks a little bit cleaner. Okay, part C adds a third mass. There is no friction between block 3 and the table. Bo, how does adding block 3 change the free body diagrams?
Well, there is a force of gravity 3 down on block 3. and a force normal up on block 3 caused by the table. And adding block 3 changes the tension forces. Now we need to label the tension force up on block 1, tension force 1, which has the same magnitude as the tension force 1, which acts to the left on block 3. And we need to label the tension force up on block 2, tension force 2, which has the same magnitude as the tension force 2, which acts to the right on block 3.
Billy, could you please solve for the new acceleration of the system?
The net force on all three blocks in the same positive direction as before is force of gravity 2 minus tension force 2 plus tension force 2 minus tension force 1 plus tension force 1 minus force of gravity 1, which all equals the total mass times acceleration. All the tension forces cancel out, and we can substitute in the same equations as before, only now the total mass also includes the mass of block 3. So the acceleration expression is almost the same, it just adds the mass 3 in the denominator. Therefore, adding block 3 increases the value of the denominator, which will decrease the acceleration of the block.
Correct. Now, I will point out, because the question only asks you to explain how you arrived at your answer for what happens to the magnitude of the acceleration of block 2 when you add block 3, you do not have to derive the acceleration like we did right here. You could just explain it using Newton's second law. You could explain that adding block 3 does not change the net force acting on the system. Therefore, because it increases the mass of the system, it must therefore decrease the acceleration of the system and therefore decrease the acceleration of block 2. Again, that is an explanation, which is what they asked for. I did a derivation because I feel like you understand it a little bit better when we walk through the whole thing. For you, for example, you understand why the net force, the addition of block 3, does not change the net force acting on the system. One other thing. Notice that free response question number 1 had absolutely no numbers in it. So, as I've said before, please let go of your numbers dependency. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.